This video is for people who want a clear, simple explanation of Python lists in simple English. Okay, we continue with programming in simple English with Python lists. A Python list is an array in other programming languages, just a collection of items. So we can have a collection of integers or strings or a mixture. So we can have integers, strings, floats, lists inside lists, and even booleans. An empty list is declared using either empty square brackets or using the word list with round brackets following it. We can just print the list. Notice that on the output we have the square brackets, which is important that you know that when there's a list. We can use the key term in. So here we have x, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And we can say 3 in x, we will have a boolean true. And 8 in x is false. We can add lists together, called concatenation. We normally, if we want to print a list, we print it by each item. So we can use a for loop. So for example here we iterate with I, so we have 4i in x, and then we print I, and that will print each member of the list x. In Python the list is quite similar to strings, so you'll see quite a few similar functions and ways strings can be used and lists can be used, but they're not the same. Here we have a string hello, and if we try to change the first letter in the string it won't allow it, whereas lists it will. So here we have the list of hello, and we want to change the first element to an uppercase H, and it will allow us to do that. If we want to change something in a list, we can use the index. So for example, the index 0 will change the first value. So in this example, we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. We change the first element to 0. So we now have 0, 2, 3, 4, 5. We can also access the list using an index from the back of the list, the end of the list, using minus numbers. So minus 1 signifies the last member in the list, the last value. So in this example we're going to change the value 5 to 8, so we end up with the 0, 2, 3, 4, 8 list. So again, similar to strings, we look at the index. Here we have the list x. We look at x0 and x6 is going to be letters H and W, and x0 plus x1 is going to put the or concatenate the two letters together, or H and E, the first two letters. Again, the same if we try to access something in a list that's not there, we use a number of an index that's too high, then we get this out of range error message. As we know from strings, if we want to go from 0 to 7, we're going to get from the first character to the 7th. From 0 to 1 will be the first character, and we don't need to put the 0 in. We can just use the square brackets and the colon with a number after. If we're going to do a partial string, we can use the first number to the second number. We can do it to the end. And if we do it to the end, we don't need to put that number in either. We can have the number, then colon, and leave the end number blank as well. So we can access the list using indexes from 0 upwards. So here we have the list that has the indexes from 0 to 11. And if we want to complete the whole list, then we can just use the square brackets with the colon. We don't need to put the 0 and the last number in. So you may think this is very similar to strings we looked at before. So here's almost identical example, except the letters are in a list rather than a string, and we access them using the same indexes and the same slices, if you like. So 3 to the end is DEF, 2 to 5 is CDE, and the first characters up to 3 is ABC. So you can use the example with the boxes, or perhaps you prefer the idea of the pie or the circle with the values in. Again, with lists, we have built-in functions. So again, similar to strings, we can use length, and that will give us the length of the list. So it has 5 values, the output will be 5 if we put len x. We can add items to the list, and we use append for this. So here we append the letter s, and that will go at the end of the list. If we append another list, we end up with that list inside our list. Not the values inside the list, but the whole list. So be very careful here. Notice the output, we've got the square brackets, which is our list, but we've also got square brackets inside, meaning we have a list of H-E-L-L-O strings and another list with strings inside. If you don't want to put that list inside the list, you just want to add the other string values, you can use the extend built-in function. So here we've added the list values inside. So here we have hello world all in just the one list. There are other built-in functions. You're probably not likely to use that much, but here are some examples. Insert, so you can insert the value at set position, so it can be useful if you want to put it at the beginning, so insert 0. Or if you want any number, you can insert that value at that place. And if you want to find a value and where about in the list it is, you can use index. So in this example, we have index E, which is not at 0 but at 1, and index L, we have output 2, because that's the place of the first occurrence, the first match of that string L. So that's index. There are two ways to sort a list. In this example, we have X is H-E-L-L-O, and we can create another list Y using the word sorted and X in brackets. Another way to sort the X list itself would be just to say X.sort empty brackets. Either way, we output X or Y, we have E-H-L-L-O. So that's sort and sorted. Now, slightly more complicated, you can have lists inside lists. So you could actually use this if you wanted to represent something in two dimensions, for example. So here we have a list 1 and 2, we call X, a list 8 and 9, we call Y, and then we could put both these lists inside Z. So we have Z is a list that contains two parts, and both those parts are lists. So if we want to print Z, we can see the two square brackets, the bracket of the list of Z and also the brackets inside, saying that X and Y are in there as lists rather than just 1, 2, 8 and 9. So if we print Z1, it's going to be the second element. It's not going to be 2, it's going to be 8, 9, which is a list. And if we want to access just one of the numbers, for example 8, we have Z square brackets 1, so means the second element, and then 0, which means the first element. So the first element in the second list, which is 8. So that's lists inside another list. Okay, now let's test your knowledge in the quiz. Question one. Quite straightforward. We have x, which is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. What happens if we print x with minus 1 in square brackets? What does that print? Another one, if we print 5 in x, what will happen there? That's question one. Question two. Update each value in the list x to double the value. So we want to make each value 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 into its double the value, so times by 2. So we're going to end up with x being 2, 4, 6, 8, 10. So that's question 2. Question 3. Now we need to change the three middle values so they equal 0. So instead of 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, we're going to have 1, 0, 0, 0, 5. That's question 3. Question 4, we've got the same list and we want to swap the first two elements, which are 1 and 2, with the last two, which are 4 and 5, which is going to end up with a list of 4, 5, 3, 1, 2. That's question 4. And finally, question 5. Here we have a list of x, which is 2, 3, 1, 5, and 4, and we want to make a copy of that and call it y. And then we want y to be put in order, so it's going to be a sorted list. And then we're going to create another list z and then put x and y inside z. And finally, we need to access the first number of both the enclosed lists. So z is going to have two lists inside. How do we get the first element of both those lists? That's question 5. Question 1. What would these print? Well, the first one was the last element. X minus 1 accesses the last element in the list, so that would output 5. And is 5 in the list? Yes, so the output is a boolean true. That's question 1. Question 2. How do we double the numbers? Well, we can use the for loop and then just multiply each number by 2. So here we have I goes through each element and we just multiply x with I as the index times 2. That's question 2. Question 3, we just use a substring. So we want elements 1 to 4 and change them to 0. So we can do that quite easy using the zeros in a list. So x 1 to 4 equals 0, 0, 0, and that will print 1, 0, 0, 0, 5 as x. That's question 3. Question 4 is interesting. How do we swap the first two elements with the last two? Well, if we write all the elements down, that's x, 0, 1, minus 2 and minus 1 would be the last two, remember. And now we can equal them to minus 2, minus 1, 0 and 1, so they swap places. So that's quite an easy way in Python how we can swap values. That was question 4. Finally, question 5. So here we have x. We can make a copy of x by just using the colon by itself. So we make that into y. y.sort will put them in order. And then we can put x and y in z. So z equals x and y in square brackets. How do we get the first element? The first element is going to be 0 in brackets. How do we get the first element of both lists? Well, it's going to be z, 0, 0, and z, 1, 0. And that would output 2 and 1. The first element in x is 2, and the first element in the ordered list is going to be number 1. So that one, did you get that right? That was question 5. Okay, we've come to the end. So we're going to finish with a question. Can you make a list into a continuous circle? Okay, any answer, please put in a comment and put it below. Please remember to subscribe if you haven't already. And now, if you want to review the code, you can listen to the music and see all the code again. Okay, bye for now. Thank you.